What's up, Kurlfriendz? If you want to see me go from wet and soaked hair to dry in this voluminous wash and go, then just keep on watching. So I'm starting off on freshly washed hair, and I'm using the Oats and Honeys Leave-In Conditioner by Mielle's, which y'all know is one of my favorite brands. And I must say, this leave-in conditioner was super moisturizing. I really loved this leave-in conditioner. So I'm speeding the video up because I don't really want to concentrate too much on this part. So I just want to show you how I originally got the moisture into my hair. And now we're moving on to what I'm using for the wash and go. So this is my leave-in growth cream that I created. And I'm using the Jamaican Black Castor Oil, followed by the Big Poppa Hair Gel by Doux. And it smells amazing.
It smells like pineapples.
All right, so now I'm sectioning off my hair, and I'm going to start adding the Jamaican Black Castor Seed Oil to this section. And you want to make sure that you're always working in sections, because this is going to be less overwhelming for you, especially if you're a beginner to natural hair. Always work in sections, and technically you should anyway. That way your section in your hair is getting the full effect of the products. So now what you just seen me do, I added the Jamaican Black Castor Seed Oil first, then followed by my product, and I added the gel to it. So I basically want to see if they were a good match. And basically what you do is you take the styler that you're using, which is my leave-in hair growth cream. And then I took the gel, the Doux Big Poppa's hair gel, and then I just mixed them together. And as you've seen, there was no clumps. It was like a smooth consistency, and that's what you want. It shouldn't clump up. It should basically mix together effortlessly. And if it doesn't do that, then it's not a great combination and you shouldn't use it. So I'm going to show you here in just a moment how I confirmed if this was a good combination. Okay, so here we go again. I am taking my leave-in growth cream and I'm adding the gel to it, and I'm just mixing it onto my palm. And as you've seen, there was no clumps. It wasn't dry looking. It mixed together perfectly. So now I'm just brushing through my hair just to make sure that it is nicely detangled and that the product is getting through all of my strands. And then I'm just using the raking method to try to bring in as much definition as possible. But what I did notice, guys, is that I rinsed my hair with cool water, and I'm using cool water to re-moisturize my hair as well, when technically my water should be warm. It shouldn't be hot, but it should be like lukewarm so that my cuticles stay open. And what happened was my cuticles were shut. So that's why my product isn't like defining or clumping my strands. So learn from me and make sure that you're using lukewarm water if you have low porosity hair. That is very important, because once we close up the cuticles, it's going to be hard for the product to penetrate our strands. So make sure you're using lukewarm water, never hot, because that causes damage to the cuticles. Okay, so I'm going to let you continue to watch me finish this up, and then we'll move on to what I did next. Okay guys, so I'm just gonna clip up my hair because I was trying to keep it elongated as long as possible, but as you can see here, that did not work. So I end up stretching it with the bands, and this is the outcome of the first day, which I really liked it, but let's get into the second day. So after I rebanded it, restretched it, this is the outcome, and I really love this outcome. This is the second day, and I feel like it just came out more voluminous, and the hair moved so much better. I just really loved it. So make sure you leave me a comment. Let me know which one you really liked. Was it the first or the second one? And if you have not subscribed to the channel, make sure you join your Kurlfriendz, and I'm going to see you back on the next one. Peace.